Speed. For centuries, man has been consumed with the overwhelming desire to go faster, to bend the laws of velocity and acceleration for the visceral thrill almost nothing else can match. Finally, the physical embodiment of that long sought-after need for speed has been born. Up ahead, the road appears empty, yet something approaches. It comes into focus. A masterwork of sound, beauty, and sheer power. Speeding art with an attitude. The fastest commercially available roadster ever created. Behold a crowning achievement in automobile technology. The 1200 horsepower, carbon fibered Bugatti Veyron Grand Sport Vitesse. Legendary carmaker Bugatti has long been synonymous with the principles of performance, design, and technology. An adherence to these lofty ideals has resulted in the ultimate automotive achievement. Bugatti's headquarters in Molsheim, France, leads a team of more than 120 engineers, devoted to the creation of automobile perfection. Bugatti has raised the bar once more in the competitive world of supercars. Bugatti has taken the soul of the powerful Veyron Sport and placed it into the body of a roadster. A simple task? Think again. It takes the best in engineering and the sheer determination to push the boundaries of automotive innovation. The task of creating a monstrously powerful roadster with refinement and grace begins with a redesign under the hood. Engineer Jens Schulenburg discusses technology and process.
I'm one of the 120 developed engineers of Bugatti. I started 11 years ago to make the first prototype of the Bugatti Veyron Duramas. And we learned lots of things in the last 11 years about the dynamics of super sport cars. So we started with the Veyron, we made the Grand Sport, the first open version, and then we optimized with this both cars, the super sport and the last one is the Bugatti Grand Sport Vitesse.
The addition of two fuel pumps and four enlarged turbochargers and intercoolers has served to bulk up the Veyron Grand Sport's already monstrous 7.9-litre 16-cylinder engine, resulting in an almost incomprehensible 1,200 horsepower. But to handle the additional power, Bugatti reinforced the drivetrain, including the powerful 7-speed dual-clutch gearbox. More horsepower means more speed and more heat, thus throwing the gauntlet down to the engineers and designers at Bugatti.
The heat management is one of the biggest challenges in a car like this. So we have 882 kilowatts of heat in the radiators, and that must be cooled down, and we must be sure we can use that car also in the desert or in the wintertime. So it's a little different focused like other sport cars, but this car is usable every day.
Without compromise, the engineers at Bugatti opened up the front end, allowing for additional cooling capabilities to offset the increase in heat generated by the more powerful engine. The aerodynamic redesign of the front end led to changes in the look and functionality of the Vitesse's rear end, as a new double diffuser and super short exhaust were added. Bugatti's John Hill breaks down the key features of the Vitesse.
There's an interesting story from when our chairman, Dr. Piek, met with the engineers for the first time. He gave them criteria around which they were to design a car. The first was that he was looking for a car with over 1,000 horsepower, 0 to 100 kilometers in less than 3 seconds, top speed over 406 kilometers per hour, and all of that, and you must be able to drive it to the opera and not be embarrassed. So don't just build a beast, but build an elegant car that can perform better than the fastest race cars in the world. And I think if you look at the beauty of this car, I mean, it's really a work of art that performs like no other car in the world.
The offer was to make a beauty and a beast. The beauty must be a very drivable car. It must run, must go cruising. It must have a good fuel consumption from an engine like this. And if you open the throttle, it must be the beast. Generate 1,200 horsepower, generate 1,500 newton meters of torque, and accelerate in 2.6 seconds to 60 miles. That must be handled. If you want to have a sporty car, everything must be very tight, very stiff. And if you drive comfortable, you have the opposite side. To find the right way to do both of this, that was a big challenge.
The Vitesse is able to handle this increased power thanks to several key upgrades to the Grand Sports Engineering. Firstly, the Vitesse received an enhanced suspension, which helps the open road vehicle handle the increased power and quicker acceleration. But the changes didn't stop there. The Vitesse boasts an all-carbon fiber body. This change is a leap forward from the Grand Sport's carbon-aluminum blend in terms of reduced weight and increased strength. Let's call a spade. In Bugatti's native French, Vitesse means speed. Vitesse can accelerate from a standing start to just over 60 miles an hour in a ridiculous 2.6 seconds. For those thrill seekers in search of an adrenaline rush unbeknownst to most, you'll need a key to unlock the top speed opportunity, thus allowing the driver to accelerate to mind-bending speeds well over 233 miles per hour. And while the Vitesse may not be able to drive itself to the dealership if it encounters a performance issue, the geniuses at Bugatti monitor each Vitesse from a command center in France. Often, they'll know about any issues before the owner and quickly alert them. Bugatti has spared no expense in creating the Vitesse, from titanium bolts at every connection to an interior constructed of carbon fiber, aluminum, and magnesium. For those who have had the good fortune to experience the Vitesse, the open road will never be the same. And for $2.6 million, it can make you the envy of everyone, with a sense of adventure and a desire for speed.